Serious people of Reddit who almost died. What's your story? I was getting radiation treatment and chemo and both of my lungs ended up collapsing. At the time I was the 7th person ever to have it happen and survive in the state of New York. Truly a 1 in a million chance of survival. I was in 5 bus crashes, all different drivers, within 2 to 3 years in elementary school, and then another car crash maybe a year after, that which was more serious than the bus ones. Almost got hit by a guy who ran a red light going about twice the speed limit, basically had a mini life crisis, and realized I never accomplished anything and that, if I did die I wouldn't have been proud of the life I lived. After 2 weeks I kind of just moved on though. I'm allergic to wheat. In many years I didn't know, and I slowly became very thin to a point where I had walking. Then one day I had to make dinner, and I chose to make pizza. I noticed that my hands began to itch a lot, and some days after I took an allergy test, it came back positive. In just 1 month I gained 10 kilograms from stopping eating wheat. Apparently when I was very young I almost drowned in a pool, if it wasn't for my mother. According to her, cause I have no memory of this, she said that I was playing outside and suddenly a splash, she ran and took a look at the pool and there was I, sitting in the floor looking at her in the surface, and tangled in a net. She then states that she managed to save me when I extended my arms at her, so she could pull me up. Since she doesn't know how to swim, and the pool was somehow deep for her. Chickened out on killing myself years ago, woke up in the ICU days later. When I was a kid, I went to a neighborhood BBQ, and while playing hide and seek I was seeking a boy that hid under the porch with a rope, so when I came near him, he jumped out, and put it around my neck, and started strangling me. Still don't like anything touching my neck. I had in my intestines block up on me back in November of 2016, days before my birthday, and the doctor told me that if I hadn't shown up for another few hours, well I could have never typed this. I was once being treated for a problem in my kneecap. 3 injections were to be injected in my leg. After the 3rd injection, I suddenly had a panic attack and the medicine flew into my veins, which caused my body to force out the medicine. Till the medicine won't go out, my body won't inhale any more oxygen, and I could see myself stopping to breathe. My father was down there trying his best to do something but nothing seemed to work, and seemed like he gave up. After 1 minute and 20 seconds, for which I hadn't inhaled oxygen, my body successfully threw out the medicine, and started taking oxygen again, and I was somehow saved. I now prefer to live with a disabled leg, than having it treated again, and taking the risk. Had a rare blood disease when I was like 4. People in my family still talk about it like it was the worst time of their lives. It makes me feel guilty because they went through that, but I couldn't really do anything about it. Mother nearly died while pregnant with me. Fell out of the 2nd story window as an infant. Brother pulled me out of the way of a car. Slit my wrist when I slipped. Accidentally stabbed in the back. Hit a deer on the interstate. Jumped out of a tractor before it crashed and broke in two. Nearly got hit by a falling window. Nearly got hit by a tram. Probably forgetting some. When I was a baby I had a broviac line in my chest. For antibiotics I have cystic fibrosis and the line got infected and my blood became infected. I was having seizures and basically died, and they resurrected me in the hospital and saved my life. Here I'm 22 years later. Double lung pneumonia on Christmas, while I was already suffering from asthma, when I was 7. I accepted that I was probably going to die, and felt bad that I spoiled my family's enjoyment. In a lake on a circle thingy, me and my twin brother ignored our parents' warnings about us being too light for it, and we nearly drowned. I think I blacked out, but either way our parents pulled us back to the boat, and saved us. I was struck by lightning. All I can remember is a bang, then a thud, then I'm in an ambulance. I hurt a lot and a few of my blood vessels had burst, but luckily nothing major, so I was bruised for a while, but didn't have internal bleeding. I also had a lot of cardiology tests over the course of about a year, but they just kept proving my heart was fine, so I got discharged, pun not intended. I'd been leaning against something, and we think it took the majority of the force from the strike and I just got the leftover bit. Only thing I have now is I can't use touch screens. I think this was when I was around the age of 5. I really loved motorbikes back then, but while we were around this big track for motorbike riding, But one day I was riding around it, and I had seen this car. I thought, hey, it won't go on the track, and guess what happened? It went in front of me, while riding my motorbike. Luckily I was smart enough back then, to jump off of my motorbike. The people driving the car had a heap of paint taken off their car, and got lots of dents in the door. Serves them right. My appendix burst, when I was 16, and it went gangrene. They were going to do keyhole surgery to treat it, but ended up needing to open me up. The gangrene was slowly poisoning my blood, and I got so poorly, that I flatlined during the operation. Ah. Me, when I was 8. Bear in mind this was 1979, so a keyhole was a thing, that a key went into. Missed their appendix burst, while they were operating. I felt mine go the second I stepped foot in the entrance of the hospital. It was bad enough dealing with that pain, when I was 16. Can't imagine how you felt at age 8. I had myocarditis in 2012, I think. It feels so long ago. I remember a bunch of doctors like flooding into my hospital room after the first doctor left. They all looked kinda wide-eyed and anxious. Ick, now the look you give someone, when you know they're gonna die. Yay, that look from all of them. Someone said it was 50-50, but I'm pretty sure the chance of living was at least a little higher than that. After googling it, it sure felt like I was gonna die, I can tell you that. Down at 20s in X bars, blacked out and fell out of my window, woke up with a fractured back, and skull a day later, told I cold easily died, had I fallen at any other angle. Oh, and this was last Wednesday. I was riding my bike on my way to my school sports hall, didn't want to stop at a red light, because I was already running late and there was not a single car in sight. As I was about to cross, a car suddenly comes from the highway going about 40 over the speed limit. I barely managed to slam on both brakes, and came to a stop within a meter. The car missed me by about 20 centimeters. If I hadn't recently gotten my brakes replaced, I don't know if I'd be writing this right now. I apologize though, since it was partially my fault. Shouldn't have tried to run that red light. But well, this was about 2 years ago, never did it again since. H mother had signed me up for a ski camp in the middle of Florida during summer. I know it sounds really sketchy. During the camp, I fell multiple times in a way that my kneecaps felt like they were going to break. I still am slightly scared of going to ski. Almost wasn't born, I was 12 days late coming out, and they had to perform an emergency C-section on my mum when they realized my heart was about to stop. Swallowed a bottle of Tylenol. Rather than dying, I just pukes blood for an entire day in a hospital. Wouldn't recommend. Had a motorbike crash at age 7 driving my 50cc through a kiwi fruit orchard. Head first into a wooden post, the impact fractured my skull, and left an incision that completely exposed the skull underneath. My mother said it looked like a second mouth, but on my forehead, because of the red flesh and white of the bone. Had I not been wearing my helmet, I'd have been very dead. Walked away a week later with mild swelling, 13 stitches and remarkably no serious brain damage. As far as I know, I still have the scar on my forehead, although it no longer spans the majority of it anymore as I've grown up. About 3 years ago I took 600 Benadryl tablets and almost died. I don't really remember much, but being rushed to the hospital and the dumb girl taking my blood pressure 5 times, because it can't be that low. I now have a resting heart rate of 120, and I have a hard time eating. I can't take those pills anymore, and my mom has a hard time looking me in the eye sometimes. So many people acted like they cared, but in reality none of them really did. They only cared when I was dying, but as soon as I was done they went right back to not talking to me. Attempted suicide. Tried to hang myself, but the ceiling fan broke, so I went to a bridge, where a friend was luckily there, and talked me out of it, while I was 1 foot off the bridge. I don't know if I should thank him or not, because my life still isn't worth living, and I'd gladly die if it saved someone else. Back when I was in high school near the end of the year, I let my pride get the best of me, and didn't take any money from my parents to eat lunch. Because of some reason I can't remember, I didn't eat lunch and my stomach ended up eating itself. Long story short, I threw up blood, and went to the hospital, and had to take 9 pills in the morning, afternoon and night. For 6 months 0-10 won't recommend. Moral of the story, if people want to help you, and you know you need it, don't let your pride get in the way. I did a 4-hour drive to a wedding, then found out the axle on my car was broken. If it had slipped loose while I was going 80 miles per hour, I would be toast. I've had 2 heart transplants, one when I was 10 months and one when I was 9. The first one was because I was born with dilated cardiomyopathy, and the second one because I rejected the first one. I don't remember a cause. I was less than a year old, came down with a bad case of pneumonia, was at a hospital for a while, and doctors eventually called my parents to come and spend their last moments with me. Mom was devastated as she lost her first child before me. I was expected to succumb to whatever was going on with my lungs, but lingered for a while, and then started getting better a few days later. Took an overdose of this sleeping anti-anxiety drug I was prescribed. The limit was around 800 milligrams. That amount is only given by a doctor and administered. I took my entire box of them, which was around 1500 milligrams. I also mixed it with some heavy painkillers. It could have killed me easily, but I only ended up sleeping for 20 hours. Wouldn't recommend. I'm getting help for my problems, so no need to worry. I went to a carnival that only comes around every summer when I was 3. I was in a bounce house. The bounce house started collapsing. I didn't leave because I was a dumb 3-year-old. My dad went in and saved me, but not before being blocked by the police, because it was dangerous for him to be in there. Eventually he got past them and saved me before I suffocated. I forgot to mention this was a year after I got my arm broken by the slide. We don't visit the place anymore. At 19 years old, I had an illicit drug-induced cardiac arrest while longboarding around the streets of my hometown. Just remember excruciating pain and falling off, then waking up in hospital. Got clean as soon as I was released from hospital, but the bit they don't tell you about getting off of the drugs is that you will still miss the high and the feelings, but I could never go through that again, which is why I'm still clean. 9th grade. I got a minor cut on my leg that ended up getting infected with MRSA. I didn't bother telling anyone until the wound on my leg was oozing black pus. My mom brought me to the hospital, where they quarantined me from the other kids in the pediatric wing. My doctor said, if I waited another day I wouldn't have made it. I suffered severe anorexia and wound up starving myself down to 82 lbs. My treatment team told me, if I had waited any longer to get help and lost any more weight, my heart would have given out. Black Widow was about bite my hand, and I was home alone. A couple of years ago I used to run around on rooftops and other high places. This one time I was balancing on the edge and a big chunk of the roof fell loose from the rest of the roof. This made me lose grip and fall. I managed to grasp onto the edge with my hands and pull myself up, but man, rooftops are scary. I was 5, and I split my head open on concrete. When I was 3 I slipped in a pool and almost drowned. I'm not sure if this counts, but my autistic brother once rocked a canoe I was in to scare me. I said, don't rock the boat. It will flip over. You all can see what happens next. It was in shallow water. I knocked out on a rock, but my bro was fine. I had a life vest, but I was trapped under the canoe. I was then dragged out of the water, and I'm fine today. I was skateboarding, and was trying a handrail that was square, and had pretty sharp corners. Anyway, I got onto the rail, and slipped out, and came about a centimeter from caving in the back of my skull. I didn't realize this until I saw the footage of the fall that my friend had filmed, and at the speed I was going, and if I hit my head, it definitely had brain damage, and probably would have been in a coma. I still don't wear a helmet, BTW. I don't remember the year, but I was walking to my home and almost died because of an ignorant minibus driver. My mother pulled me from death on the last second. This happened in Istanbul. When I believe I was 7, 8-ish, I had a severe asthma attack and stopped breathing. This asthma attack gave me ridiculous hallucinations that sparked irrational fears I still have today. Luckily for me, our local fire chief lived a few houses down and ran over and gave me oxygen from a tank she brought. Saved my life. I almost got ran over while visiting England. I dragged behind my family, who was walking much faster than me. I eventually got to a crosswalk and tried to catch up to them, and the crosswalk light went red. Soon enough, a red double-decker bus comes hurling around the corner. I ran for my life and eventually made it to the sidewalk. That was the last time visiting England. Plus, I don't want to fly from Japan to the UK.